السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. حمدا ومصليا أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق. صدق الله العظيم. Respected President, Distinguished Judges and dear audience, I'm going to deliver a speech on the topic Necessity of Education in Muslim Society. Dear audience, the world has witnessed to the golden period when the educational field was dominated by Muslims. Muslims were the fountainhead of all sciences, irrespective of religion. People around the world distilled sherbet from this resourceful tree of knowledge to satisfy their educational thirst. But unfortunately, today the Muslim nation is lagging behind in all spheres throughout the world, mainly because of educational backwardness. The pathetic fact must be admitted that Muslims ignored the importance of education given by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and therefore they are steeped in ignorance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made education a source of enlightenment, leading to both religious and secular accomplishment from the very first day. Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wa salam was bestowed distinctive honor of education in comparison with angels. Later on, the last prophet of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was given the treasure trove of knowledge in the shape of the glorious Quran, which has unparalleled guidance and eternal solution to all the problems, if only Muslims had time, patience, and strength of iman to benefit from it. Let's turn to some bright pages of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life, in which he practically proved himself as a knowledge-friendly person, which galvanized the Sahaba to learn from his words and actions. Once Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered a masjid, and he saw two groups engaged in two different activities. The first group was in the praise and prayer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while the other group was learning and teaching. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled, and then he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ مُعَلِّمًا. I have been sent as a teacher. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam joined the group which was learning and teaching and became actively involved in their work. In the Battle of Badr, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam contacted the captives to benefit from their teaching skills. This showed that he had no hesitation from encouraging the Sahaba to learn even from war prisoners, which is the clear point and all the emphasis given by Islam on the necessity of education. The war prisoners were not acquainted with Islam, so the question of acquiring Islamic knowledge from them did not arise. But the fact remains that common education that benefits all should be sought from everyone. This is the message the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given us. Dear audience, in Islamic perspective, as it is compulsory to learn authentic religious knowledge of every sphere of life to be a good Muslim, likewise, for individual and collective needs, education in the fields of science, technology, research, political and social sciences should be encouraged. The beauty of Islamic system is that modern education can be a part of religion if it is informed with good intention. Allah Almighty says in the very five verses of the glorious Quran, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Read. The word اقرأ is not specified for any topic. Read in the name of your Lord who created man with a clinging cloth. Read, your Lord is the most compassionate for all, who has taught with the power of pen, taught man that which he knew not. Dear audience, we need to establish schools, colleges and universities to teach good morals and manners and knowledge to the young generation. Otherwise, the youth of today's generation will go astray. It is time to walk on the youth. And if we run schools, colleges and universities, we can spend maximum time and energy with students and nurture the values, inculcate the morals and manners, guide them to walk into the footsteps of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and to remove the widespread corruption from our society. We can purify and educate their hearts, which is the soul and which is the spirit of education. education, as it is likely said, education of the heart is the heart of education. Educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. We must learn from the glorious Quran and the practical life of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that all kinds of knowledge are necessary for survival in today's world. And authorities and intellectuals must try to make it affordable to the poor so that equity of opportunity may be given to all. Here is the clear message for the whole world that the candle of knowledge must be lit in every heart, because success comes only to those people who have acquired knowledge, not only to get ahead in worldly matters, but also to strengthen and to deepen the relationship with Allah. How beautifully Allama Iqbal has composed the couplet, Pigalna ilmke khatir misale shamae zeba hai, bagair uske nahi pehchan sakte hum khuda kya hai. Without being able to dissolve or burn up for seeking knowledge like a lighted candle, it is not possible for a person to perceive the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I wind up my speech with a beautiful quote of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Live as if you are to die tomorrow. Learn as if you are to live forever. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the understanding of our beautiful religion and its all-encompassing teachings of pure and considerate moral and ethics. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.